Good morning student, welcome to online classes. In previous session we have discussed what is trigonometry and its t ratio, the values of t ratio, how many t ratios are there. In this session we have discussed sine of t ratio. T ratio means trigonometry ratio. Sine of trigonometry ratio in different quadrants, or it is called ASTC formula, ASTC rule. So what is ASTC formula, what is ASTC rule? Now we have discussed. First of all, in this session we have to discuss first quadrant. So it is a plane if two lines perpendicular with each other and intersect a point, suppose O, and it is perpendicular to each other. Two lines divides into plane, divides into four parts. So each part is called quadrant. So as you know, it is a first quadrant, it is second quadrant, it is third quadrant, and it is fourth quadrant. Because it has some positive angles, so positive angles, so we are numbering them in anticlockwise direction. So it is first one, Q1, that means first quadrant, Q2, Q3 and Q4. So that is the value of 0 degree and that is 90 degree. So Q1 lies in 0 degree to 90 degree and Q2 lies 90 degree to 180 degree. And in Q3, if we add them 90 degree, so we get 270 degree. So Q3 is lies 180 degree to 270 degree. Similarly, in Q4 or fourth quadrant, if we add 270 plus 90, that we get 360 degree. That is fourth quadrant. Similarly, if we add them 90 degree, we get 450. Similarly, 540. Similarly, we can add them 90 degrees, so we get the value of the quadrant. So in first quadrant, that means 0 degree 90 is equal to 360 to 450. 90 to 180 is also Q2, and we can read as 450 to 550 is also a second quadrant. Similarly, we add them, we get the result. Now, what is the ASTC formula? ASTC formula means here is in first quadrant A. ASTC formula means A, S, T, C. Right? In systematic way, A, S, T, C. A for here, A for all. That means all are positives. Here S. S means sign is positive. Here T, that means 10, 10 is positive, and here C, that is cos, is positive. Cos is positive. Now in first quadrant, all are positives, that means all T ratio are positives. Here Q2, sin is positive. Sin is related to, in previous class we discussed, sin is related to cosec. So sin is positive, that means cosec is also positive. Similarly, 10 is positive, 10 is related to cot. So 10 and cot both are positive. In fourth quadrant, cos is related to sec, so cos and sec both are positive. And how to, in this ASTC formula, how to detect which value is positive and negative in this diagram, we can calculate it easily. Now, we take some examples. So first, we write some notes here to understand clearly. First point, in Q1 means first quadrant. In first quadrant, All positive means all T ratios are positive. Now the second point, that is Q2. In Q2 means second quarter, which is lies between 90 to 180, or we can say 450 to 550. In Q2, sine and cosine, that means sine theta or cosine theta is positive, other PSU are negative. That means in second quadrant, only sine and cosine are positive and other PSU are negative. In Q3, in third quadrant, here tan and cot are positive. You can write tan theta or cot theta are positive, and other P ratios are negative. And the last one, in fourth quadrant, Q4, cos and sec are positive, that means the negative is cos theta and sec theta are positive, and other T ratios are negative. So now we have discussed, or we take some examples to understand clearly and thoroughly. Now take examples. Suppose sine 203, we have to check it is positive angles or negative angles. Now in these questions, first we get it angles. Here angle is 203. First we have to detect 203 lies in which quadrant. 203 means it lies in third quadrant. 203 degree is lies in third quadrant. In third quadrant, tan and cot are positive, but here is sine. So it is positive or negative? It is negative angles. But how to detect the negative angles? Because its angle is 203 degree, and 203 degree lies in third quadrant. In third quadrant, only tan and cot are positive, but here sine. So sine is negative in case of third quadrant. Similarly, we take another example. Tan 333 degree. Is it a positive angle or negative angle? Now your angle is 333 degree. 333 degree is lies in Q4, or we can say fourth quadrant. In fourth quadrant, only cos and sec are positive, but here it is tan. So it is positive or negative? It's also negative. Now we take cosec 78 degree. Cosec 78 degree. Is it positive angle or negative angle? Now first we write value of angle is 78 degree, and 78 degree lies in first quadrant. In first quadrant, it lies 0-90, or you can say 360 to 450. So 78 degree lies in first quadrant. In first quadrant, all are positive. So it is a positive angle. It is a positive angle. Similarly, we take another example. Suppose cot 400 degree. It is a positive or negative? Now 400 degree lies in first quadrant. In first quadrant, all are positive. So it is also positive. So in this diagram, we have to find, we have to found what is positive or negative angles. Now discuss about the limits to the value of T ratios. In first point, sine theta and cos theta cannot be numerically greater than 1. That means the maximum value of sine theta and cos theta is 1. In second point, sec theta and cosec theta cannot be numerically less than 1. That means the value of sec theta and cosec theta cannot be determined the value less than 1. Third point, tan theta and cot theta can have any numerical value. Tan theta and cot theta have any value, any numerical values. And in fourth point, the maximum value of sin theta or cos theta is 1. Maximum value of sin theta and cos theta is 1. And minimum value of sin theta and cos theta is minus 1. So maximum value is 1 and minimum value is minus 1. So it lies between plus 1, 2 and minus 1. That means in last point, sin theta and cos theta lies between minus 1 to 1. That means sin theta and cos theta lies between minus 1 to 1. Thank you.